from overseas.
Yes, whatever you want to do, tell me.
My name is Giselle Desotel, and my family is my love and joy.
Hi, this is Scott from Portland. Hey, this season I'm grateful for where I live, the great outdoors of the Pacific Northwest, the oceans, the rivers, the mountains, even the rain. It's great, and it's a great time and a great place to be alive.
Hi guys, my name is Fernando. I am from Kansas City, Missouri. I am also a Missouri State alumni. Go Bears! And since we're in this holiday season, there's a few things I love to give thanks to and for. First of all, would be God, my family and friends, and to everyone else who's been a major impact in my life. And I just want to wish everyone a happy holidays.
Hey y'all, my name's Jess, sending this video in from Oregon. Oh, there's so many things that I'm grateful for, but if I had to choose just one, I'd probably go with my friends and family, you know, my support system from back in Missouri. They're really great people. Anyways, I hope y'all enjoy the concert tonight. It's going to be a great one. Oh, goodness. Have fun.
Dear community, the world is a great place filled with lots of good people. My mom and dad say I'm going to grow up in a great big world filled with love and joy. They say someday I will grow up to be whoever I want to be. Sometimes I wonder what the world will look like when I get older. All I know is that the world is a big place. It's so big that it would take like a gazillion car rides to Grandma's house to go around the world. That's a lot. I want to change this big world by sharing the love and joy that I feel every day. I am the future. Love, a child of God who is spreading joy.
Thank you.
Bethlehem, the night the Word was born. The skies are glowing gaily, the earth in white is dressed. See Jesus in his cradle, drink deep at his mother's breast. And there, on a lonely hillside, the shepherds bow down in fear, as the heavens open brightly and God's message rings out so clear. Glory now to the Father, in all the heavens high, and peace to his friends on earth below, is all the angels cry.
Amen. CCM. We are Keltic Knot. This is our Keltic Christmas concert. And the theme of the concert this year is love and joy. And the reason for that, at this time of the year, is very fitting, since it's Advent and Christmas is just 2 weeks away, that we think about the greatest gift to us. God became man. He was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, became man, and was born for us. So right now, we are waiting for that nativity. We'll be here in 2 weeks. Does everyone have their Christmas shopping done? Man, do you have your Christmas shopping done? Let us all say a prayer and thanks for online shipping and priority mail. Thank you very much for that. But anyway, it's very fitting for us to think about where our true love and joy comes from. So we're going to play some songs that will be meditative and reflective. We just played a song called Don't Eat Jude in Bethlehem, which is Gaelic for One Night in Bethlehem. Elisa read the words in English and then sang those words in Gaelic. The next song was called Let All Mortal Flesh Keep Silence, a very reverent hymn thinking about the incarnation of God. But we're also going to play some upbeat tempo songs so that you can celebrate as well. And I saw a verse this morning I just had to read to you. This is from Psalms, where David says, "Come, let us sing with joy to the Lord and cry out to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him and praise him. Praise him with thanksgiving and sing joyful songs to the Lord." That is what we're going to do tonight. So hope you're ready to have some fun, because we are. All right, so let me introduce the band here while I've got a second. Back here in the back, our percussion specialist is Zachary McMealy. Playing keyboards for us this evening, Hayden Vaughn. Playing baritone guitar tonight and mandolin. Before I say his name, I just want to let you all know that Tim had a little medical emergency not too long ago. He had bypass surgery. He is clear to play, and he is okay, but keep Tim in your prayers, but he's really pulled off a miracle of recovery. So Tim Snyder. Singing most of our songs for us tonight, playing guitar, is Elisa Wren. Playing a variety of different instruments for you, and right next to me playing violin and singing a couple of songs for you this evening is Carolina Brumchuk. Now I say Carolina for last because I wanted to tell you that, as many of you are aware, she is from Poland. Her family came over about 10 years ago, and she still speaks fluent Polish. And so this next song that we're going to do is of Polish origin. Carolina, what is the name of that song? Okay, and what does that mean in English?
Lays in the manger.
Okay, the song that we're doing is called Infant Holy, Infant Lowly, and it is going to feature Carolina. She is going to sing the first verse in Polish for you. So off we go with Infant Holy, Infant Lowly.
Oh, yeah.
probably recognize it. It is called the Wexford Carol, and it's going to feature Carolina on violin.
Thank you.
because it has specifically the words love and joy in it. And this is an old English carol. And how many of you know, and I can't see out in the audience very well, but how many of you know what wassail is? Some people know what it is. Here we come a wassailing. All right. So in England in the 1800s, what people would do is they would get a big bowl and fill it full of liquor. And then they would have to put apples in it, and then they would mix it up, and that is called wassail. So what you do when you go wassailing is you walk around through the streets of London, you're drinking wassail, and you are wassailing, or caroling, but you're really getting a little bit drunk while you're caroling, because it's cold in London, right? It's cold there. So anyway, that is what this song entails, but we want to do it because it includes love and joy come to you. So we might cap it off with a little Irish jig for you. Carol now. We really love doing this song because it tells the life of Jesus in three very short verses, and through the changing colors of the berry of the holly bush. And then we're going to go straight into an old English carol, God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. So as soon as everyone is ready to go, I think we're good.
Oh, the holly, she bears a berry as white as the milk, and berry she bore Jesus all wrapped up in silk, and Mary she bore Jesus our Savior for to be, and the first tree that's in the green wood, it was the holly. And Mary, she bore Jesus who died on the cross. And Mary, she bore Jesus our Savior for to be. And the first tree that's in the green wood, it was the holly. Holly, holly. And the first tree that's in the green wood, it was.
And we trust in our Savior who rose from the dead. And Mary, she bore Jesus, our Savior, for to be. And the first tree that's in the green wood, it was the holly. Holly, holly. And the first tree that's in the green wood, it was.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to do another old English tune here. The song is called I Saw Three Ships Come Sailing In. And then we're going to go into a tune that's very popular in the United Kingdom. You do not hear it too often here in the United States, although occasionally you will. It's called Ding Dong Merrily on High. Now, Ding Dong Merrily on High has some glorias in it. And we're going to have a sing-along section later on. But now is a very good time for you to warm up your voices to join us on some glorias, okay? So let's get a little audience participation going here.
One, two, three.
song that tells about a story that takes place in Ireland. What happens is on St. Stephen's Day, the day after Christmas, December the 26th, some boys in a village, they will get together and they will go out into the woods and they will find a red bird and they will kill it. Now, it sounds very odd to us, but what they do is they bring the red bird back through town and they process through the town with the bird and they ask for alms, for money, for the burial of the wren. Well, what happens is people bring out quarters, pennies, dimes, Christmas snacks, Christmas goose, Christmas tea, but what happens is that since it is Ireland, the whiskey and the beer comes out, then the musical instruments come out, and then boom, you have a big Irish party. So that is what goes on. We are going to put a little jig in front of the wren and the furs called the dingle set, and if you listen carefully at the very opening of the dingle set, you will hear some reference to the wren and the fur. So, is everyone good to go? Good.
Thank you.
going to do an old traditional tune here. This is called The Holly and the Ivy. Now, this is not probably the one that you've heard before. It's kind of a take on that same song. It's very pretty. We hope you like it. This is called The Holly and the Ivy.
Thank you. how special you are. They say a picture is worth a thousand words. Every picture that has ever been taken in recorded history has a purpose, a story to tell. And then, like that, the moment is gone. That picture may be a happy, sad, or joyful moment, but it's normal. A picture captures a heartbeat in time which will never be relived again. Cherish those moments. We now live in a world where a photograph may be used to compare ourselves to others. Sometimes this makes us feel not good enough. We can feel lost in a sea of images, in a sea of people. You might be thinking to yourself, how am I any different than the billions of other people on this earth? Well, I'm here to remind you that you are unique. You are an original wave in the ocean of humanity. You are a part of God's creation, sent into this world to make memories to share and stories to tell, to communicate love to all people and spread God's joy and peace to all around. Yes, we might fall down sometimes, but that's why God sent his son, Jesus, to teach us how to forgive one another and embrace our differences. You are a unique image of the divine, worthy of endless joy and gladness. You are a child of God, destined to lavish that love, joy, and peace on all humanity. Finally, a person who is intentional about living God's plan.
One another. Let us go then to Bethlehem to see the thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that was made known to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart.
Oh, see my darling child, the angels watching hold. The world is at our door. I am your mother now. My darling child, these gifts.
Thank you.
you about the donations, the charities that you'll be donating to tonight. So,
Network, which was great to help publicize some of this. ASCII Automotive.
Thank you.
because we entered the sing-along portion of this concert. So, I invite you to sing along. I'm sure you can find most of the hymns. If you don't know them by heart, you can probably find them in the hymn book there. So, anyway, join right in and sing with us. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Dear humanity, the heartbeat is the center of all matters that pertain to the heart. Our human heart beats at an average of 80 times per minute. And so during an average lifetime, the human heart will beat more than 3 billion times. The beating of the heart orchestrates the very existence of each and every human being. Our heartbeat corresponds to a particular irreplaceable moment in our lives. The day we are born, heartbeat number one starts the long line of moments that will comprise the story of our lives. And when the bell tolls and the final day dawns for each one of us, our last heartbeat will signify the closing moments of our earthly life. We have been blessed beyond words with the precious gift of life. And we have been given a priceless opportunity to fill our hearts with the love and joy of the eternal Christmas season. Let us equally allow that same love and joy to overflow from our hearts into the hearts of all those who grace our lives by their presence among us. Blessings and peace to all from a grateful and conscientious member of God's human family.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's time for Joy to the World, and so I hope you will all join in on this one.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. made it to Mars, English, and Spanish. The most beautiful things in humanity, our languages, our culture, our faith, and everything that we have right here, with a message that I think we all need to hear today. A message that we need to take home, especially in the times we are living today in our world. That we can love, that we can embrace, and we can welcome one another. So thank you so much for helping us to prepare in this season of Advent, to prepare our hearts for welcoming the Lord, to welcome one another as we welcome God into our lives. Thank you so much.